When you had left the pirate fold, we tried to raise our spirits faint, according to her custom, all with quip and quibble quaint. But all in vain the crypt we heard, we lay in salt upon the rocks, until to somebody occurred a startling paradox.
A paradox!
A paradox, a most ingenious paradox, with quips and quibbles heard in flocks, but none to meet this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
And with the laughter on our lips, we wished you there to hear. We said if we could tell it him, how Frederick would the joke enjoy. And so we've risked both life and limb to tell it to our boy.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
With quips and quibbles, but none to beat this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox.
Ridiculous reason, to which, however, I've no desire to be disloyal. Some person in authority, I don't know who, very likely the astronomer royal, has decided that although for such a beastly month as February, 28 days of the row are plenty, 1 year in every 4, his days should be reckoned as 29. Through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if we're owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, you will easily discover that though you have lived 21 years, yet if you go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over. Dear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my figures do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox, at common sense she gaily mocked, though counting in the usual way is 21, I've been alive. Yet reckoning by my natal day, I am a little boy of 5.
He's a little boy of 5.
That paradox, that paradox, that most ingenious paradox.